Thank you. Thank you. Number 11.
Oh, it's number 11. Well, good afternoon. We're all awake now. My name is David Ball, and I am the cathedral organist and head of music ministry. And I just have a brief announcement. When Fred passed away, a lot of his musical materials, his scores, correspondences with organists and friends were donated to Christ Cathedral. And I am very proud to say that our official diocesan archives department has agreed to care for this and catalog all of Fred's materials. And I'd like to invite all of you after this service, if you'd like to head over to the Cultural Center, the Silver Building, on the second floor, the archives department has prepared a beautiful museum quality exhibit tribute to Fred Swann, our beloved organist here for many years. And more importantly, while it would be lovely if you'd all view these wonderful, I'm sure you have lots of memories that you'll remember and scores that you'll recognize, but we are all here today because Dr. Fred Swann touched our lives in some way. If you have a personal story about Fred Swann, our archives department is collecting oral histories. And if you think that story belongs in our archives, please head over to the second floor and talk to Daniela or Father Christopher Heath, our archivist, and they would love to record your story so that we here at Christ Cathedral can truly honor the legacy of Dr. Fred Swann, and so he can continue to inspire generations to come. Now I'd like to introduce Father Christopher Smith, who is the Rector Emeritus of this beautiful cathedral. He's the Episcopal Vicar for Special Projects, and most importantly, he's a fellow organist. So here's Father Christopher Smith.
Thank you, David. And good afternoon, everyone. It's really wonderful to be here with you, and in the name of Bishop Van, the Bishop of the Diocese of Orange, and the Rector Emeritus of Christ Cathedral, I would like to welcome you to this organ and choral festival in honor of Dr. Frederick Lewis Swann. One of the marvelous features of this event today is the collaboration among different Christian churches that goes into this music making. And as we share faith with one another, how beautiful to also share the gift of music. And one of the things I've said for a long time is that the key to world peace, I think, is music. So hopefully what we do here this afternoon is another step toward a world that certainly needs that. You know, every so often in our lives, we have the opportunity to meet greatness. And I've had that opportunity a few times in my life, and one of those is having met Dr. Frederick Swann. Fred was truly a magnificent human being, a magnificent organist, a magnificent musician. He is truly one of the most gracious men that I have ever met. And it was really a pleasure to work with Fred in the restoration of the Hazel Wright pipe organ. And one of the highlights of my time with Fred was when he was here on the day that we blessed the restored Hazel Wright organ. And Fred was the one that was chosen to be the one who officially signed off on the organ after the renovation was complete. So he's the one that was said to us, "She's ready to rock and roll." Well, he didn't really say that, but he did play Hazel, and he is the official person who signed off on the renovation and said she's ready. And we can hear now that she's more than ready. She is in full operation. So thank you all for making that happen in whatever ways that you have, and thank you for being here today. I would like to share with you a quote from a friend of mine who's gone to the Lord. His name is John O'Donohue, and he was a poet and a philosopher, and he wrote a book called Beauty, God's Eternal Promise. And what he wrote is this. He says, "It is as though music reaches that subtle threshold within us where the soul dovetails with the eternal." Today, may our music making and our prayer at this festival move us toward that encounter with the eternal. You are very welcome. It's wonderful to have you here today.
Thank you so much. Let me add my words of welcome to those that you've already heard. It is such an honor for me to be here in this sacred space to honor a man who means a great deal to me and has inspired countless hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of people. I'd say that each one of us has some way that Fred touched our lives and inspired us. I remember when I first encountered the Hour of Power one Sunday morning that we had stayed home from church, and I was just amazed by the music, and especially the fact that the choir was conducted by one man who also played these incredibly difficult accompaniments and wonderfully imaginative hymn settings at the organ. And from that point on, I always recorded the Hour of Power on Sunday mornings. And the first thing we did when we got home from church is I would hit rewind on our VHS player. That probably dates me a little bit. And I would watch what Fred did. When I was posting something on Facebook about this festival, a friend of mine asked, how many years did you study with Fred? And I initially said, I actually never studied with him, but I studied what he did from the beginning of my musical interests. And so in that way, I would say I have studied with Fred for over 30 years, probably longer than any of the teachers with whom I've officially studied. And I learned so much just by observing how Fred improvised in the service, how he accompanied the choir, how he directed the choir. All of these things, I think, were hugely important to me in my development as a musician. I'd like to share with you now a piece that has multiple points of connection with this room and with Fred. It is an arrangement of the Bach chorale, Come Susur Tot, Come Sweetest Death. And it was arranged by Virgil Fox for a concert he was giving for the American Guild of Organists in Philadelphia at the Wanamaker Department Store, home to the world's largest pipe organ. And he arranged this in a way that people had never heard before. Fred and Virgil worked together in their years at the Riverside Church, and Virgil was good friends with the Schulers, the founders of the Crystal Cathedral, and they had Virgil play often on the Hour of Power. In fact, there's a YouTube video you can find of Virgil playing the previous organ that is now part of this organ over in what is now the Arboretum, playing Come Sweet Death. Virgil was the one that the Schulers tapped to design Hazel, the Hazel Wright organ. And it took the organ that they had, the Rafati in the Arboretum, and combined it with the organ from Philharmonic Hall in New York City. And then there were other stops added to make this incredible instrument that you hear now. I've always wanted to play this piece on this organ, and there's something profoundly meaningful of playing it here with so many meaningful points of connection. There are two verses. The first one never gets very loud. The second one builds all the way up to full organ before dying away into silence, much like that final sunset that any of us will ever see, with the sky filled with blazing red and yellow and orange, gradually becoming darker and darker until that full darkness before the never-ending dawn. Come, sweetest death, come, blessed rest, take my hand and gently lead me on. Thank you.
Lord, have thy grace, but have light to fear, leaning on the everlasting cross. I have blessed.
Thank you. So many of the pieces that we have from Fred were written for very practical reasons. He needed something to play for the Hour of Power. He needed an arrangement to coordinate with a congregational hymn. And so in many ways, that's kind of like Johann Sebastian Bach. Whenever there was a need, he would use his skills and artistry to create something out of nothing. And we are the beneficiaries for what is left behind. I love playing Fred's pieces because I feel like they're so immediately enjoyable. And I feel like they give us a little bit of a glimpse into his joyful nature. He was a man of wit and wisdom. One of my favorite stories that I heard about Fred was when he made the move from New York, from the Riverside Church, to California, to the Crystal Cathedral, there was one cosmetic change that needed to be made. Fred was bald at a somewhat early age, and he was informed that in 1980s television, it was stronger for men to have hair. If Fred were joining the ministry these days, I think he would look pretty fabulous bald. But he was asked to get a toupee, which he did. In a recital that he played soon thereafter, the audience, it was the first time they had seen him with hair. And he played a tremendous recital, stunning, was getting curtain calls and encore after encore. And he had run out of pieces to play, and the audience was still applauding. He went to the microphone and he said, "It doesn't matter how many times you make me bow, it's not going to fall off." Wit and wisdom. As a high schooler, of course, awestruck by Fred's ability, I, in my teenage boldness, decided to write him a letter to ask a few questions about the music ministry. And at that time, I was trying to decide between a career as an ophthalmologist, an eye surgeon, versus a musician. And I knew one would make more money than the other. But Fred was who I wanted to be in many ways. So I wrote a letter to him and was so excited when I got the response, and he gave me some good information. He said, "Church music is hard." He said, it's a hard road, and there will be many challenges, and there will be a lot of work that you put in that goes without thanks. And he said, in some ways, that's as it should be. He said, "Keep your hopes high and your expectations low." And I have kept that in mind in many different situations ever since. So I give thanks in so many ways for the life of Frederick Swann, both for his humor, for his artistry, for the compositions that he has left us, as well as for his wisdom. I'd like to play now a setting of one of my favorite hymns, Amazing Grace, which he arranged. I believe it began as an improvisation to fill some time on the Hour of Power. And it's quite wonderful and compact. So I hope you enjoy this setting by Fred Swann of Amazing Grace.
Thank you. God, who sang to our ancestors in the many voices of the prophets.
God, who sang new life to your Son in his sleep of death.
God, who cares for the poor like a mother embracing her young.
We praise you for the Spirit singing in us words beyond our speaking.
God, who speaks in the voice of all creation.
We praise you for uniting us to the perfect song of praise.
God, who never ceases blessing your people.
We thank you for the gift of ministers.
God, who sings even in the silence of those who have no voice.
We thank you for the variety of voices that blend in our worship.
God, who makes the stones to shout and the stars to sing.
We thank you for the voice of instruments born of wood and metal and human creativity.
God, whose song is heard in every land and nation. Our Father in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 90. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past, and like a watch in the night. So teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Oh, satisfy us with your mercy that we may be glad and rejoice in our days. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us and establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. One of my favorite memories of Fred Swann is improvising together. We happened to play preludes for some of the conferences that happened here, and either Fred or I would say, well, let's pick a hymn tune and make variations on it. And so we would pick a hymn tune, and it was always the trick to see which of us could confound the other. And so, for example, one of us would play a variation in 5/4 time or 7/8 time and end up in a different key than where we started. And the trick, well, the other one was supposed to then follow that. And it was grand fun improvising together, and he was the consummate improviser. He was also one of the humblest people I know and one of the most self-effacing people I've ever known. I remember one concert that he gave at the Cathedral in downtown LA. It was a rainy, cold California winter night, and there may have been 100 people at that concert, if that many. And we were hanging out just before the concert, and Fred said, so, if I make mistakes, you guys just make a lot of noise. Shout and clap and carry on and run around the place so they won't hear my mistakes. A beautiful soul, a humble man. This piece that you're going to hear is a bit of a departure from what we've heard before. It is scored for choir, soloist, bass drum, and jazz pianist, which means that your accompanist will be improvising, so it will never sound the same way twice.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ken Miedema. We are thrilled to have heard the premiere performance of that beautiful and inspiring piece that you composed to honor our friend Fred Swann. For those of you who live in the Pasadena area, Ken will be performing his piece again tomorrow morning with my beloved friends, the choir of Lake Avenue Church, who are here today. My name is Julian Ravi, and I'm one of the founding directors of the Mark Thallender Foundation. It was 20 years ago that Fred Swann hosted the first of many foundation board meetings at his home in Palm Springs. We decided unanimously at that early meeting that at least 10% of offerings received at all foundation events would go towards establishing new scholarships to support organ students. Here to share some of our progress is Dr. Peter Green.
Thank you, Julian. I remember that meeting at Fred Swann's house. It was a privilege to work as the treasurer for the foundation, as chair of Visual and Performing Arts Division at Glendale College. I'm happy to let you all know that the Thallender Foundation Scholarship is the first and only organ scholarship at a community college in California. It is completely endowed and has been awarded once. We look forward to honoring another worthy student this fall. I'm delighted to introduce next you to Dr. Tom Matrone.
Thank you, Peter. I bring greetings from Evangel University in Springfield, Missouri. I'm particularly pleased to participate in today's festival honoring Fred Swann. Dr. Swann visited our campus at Evangel University, gave workshops for the American Guild of Organists, and played on the magnificent chapel pipe organ. For a festival choir of 400 singers with an attendance of over 2,000 people that day. I'm also pleased to announce that Mark Thallender Foundation Organ Scholarship is now fully endowed at the university and will be awarded this fall. Thank you for helping our organ students at Evangel University. And this afternoon, a new organ scholarship will be established. And David Ball has some exciting news to share with you.
Well, thank you, Tom. Just a quick note, thanks for coming all the way from Missouri, my home state. Missouri. Part of Fred Swann's legacy was teaching and inspiring, and I don't think he realized how far that would go, starting with his, obviously, he had private students and taught at the university level, but as Bradley said earlier, he inspired millions through his playing on the Hour of Power, and then even generations beyond that. I'm a millennial, I never saw the Hour of Power live, I watched it on YouTube. And it inspired me, and it's an honor to sit at that bench of the Hazelwright organ every week and conduct and play as he did. He was truly an inspiration to my young self a long time ago. I'm proud to say that here at Christ Cathedral, we have one of the most successful organ and choral scholar programs. Our recent graduates have gone off to places like McGill, Rice University, Yale, my own alma mater, the Juilliard School. And today, your donation will help continue the organ scholar program here at Christ Cathedral. And I think probably the greatest tribute to Fred that we can give is actually given by the organists who have played today. I was inspired by Fred. Bradley, who's the organist at the Dallas Symphony, was inspired by Fred. The next organist from the Hour of Power, the current organist from the Hour of Power, is seated in the choir. Philip, we heard him read the psalm. And during the prelude, we heard one of the current Christ Cathedral organ scholars, Hector Pitstick, play a duet with Bradley. This is what Cathedral Organ Scholar programs do. They allow young people, Hector is from Montana, and today he is here and had the great opportunity to play with the symphony musician and praise God in this wonderful event through his music. So what a legacy of faith that Fred left here through his teaching, through his playing. Let's continue that today. Mr. Kim, if you'd show the PowerPoint on the screen. If you don't have your checkbook with you, you can donate through QR code. All donations are tax deductible. Thank you very much for your support.
Let me take just a moment to thank you all so much for being a part of this very special afternoon of prayer and praise in honor of Dr. Frederick Swann, whom so many of us love so much. We hope you've enjoyed your time with us. We're grateful that you were here. Just one additional housekeeping notice and opportunity for you, as David mentioned at the beginning of our program, we have a wonderful archival exhibit for Dr. Fred Swann. Today is currently the only day you can see it, and it's open until 4 p.m. So if you want to see it, I would encourage you to swiftly make your way to the second floor of the Cultural Center, which is the silver round building over here to my right, probably your left. And if there's a big crowd there at 4 p.m., they might stay open a few minutes longer. Just tell Father Chris Heath that Lauren said it was okay. He'll love that. Now, to give us just a few words of benediction, I would like to introduce you to and invite forward Father Juan Navarro, our parochial vicar here at Christ Cathedral.
Thank you. I would like to say a few words in behalf of Father Bao Tai, that is the rector of Christ Cathedral. On behalf of Bishop Kevin Van, shepherd of the Diocese of Orange, and Father Bao Tai, rector of Christ Cathedral, once again, we welcome you on this special day when we honor one of the most excellent organists of our time, Dr. Frederick Louis Swann. Reverend Robert Schuller said many times, "Every achiever I have ever met says, my life turned around when I began to believe in me." Dr. Swann started to believe in him when he was 5 years old. He did not struggle with the idea of a choice of life. He saw clearly that music was a path of life to connect with God and his people. We can say that he was sitting behind the hazel console of this cathedral as a director of music and organists, leading, conducting, and creating in this place built to give glory to God. Today we honor Dr. Swann and celebrate what God does when we open to his grace. I want to thank Christ Cathedral Music Ministry, the Mark Talender Foundation, for making this day possible, for putting us all together to sing, worship God, and to recall how good and merciful God is. Yes, music is a gift. And we know that in the house of our Heavenly Father, there is a feast, a banquet of communion and unity where all are welcome to get in. Yes, we have yet to arrive at this house, but we know a place is prepared for us. There is hope. We can see the lights and hear the music. As St. Augustine, father of the church, said, "He who sings praise twice." Music helps us to grasp the experience of stepping out of ourselves and away from the limits of the present moment. Music has power. Music heals us when we are broken. We sing when we are happy, sad, or afraid. No matter what, sing to the Lord because he has been good to us. May the Lord be with us and protect us. May he guide us and give us strength. May he watch over us, keep us in his care, and bless us with his peace. Amen.